Very interesting, relevant tables that everyone wants to know. What will be with the elections? Netanyahu, the Likud, Gantz, who will win? Amazingly, what normally I'm doing, to see what the Torah says. So what I did is the following. I look for the best meeting in the Torah of the word Bechirot. You can see election in Hebrew, Bechirot in red, and very small sip of this year, which is 5779 for the creation of the world. Amazing. So, best meeting. Then I looked, by the way, to see where it appears in the Torah. In one chapter, in fact, it is the book of Leviticus, and few verses from 15 till 45. Unbelievable. So many verses in one chapter. By the way, very important to know that this program I'm using is Dr. Rottenberg's. He himself became religious, Orthodox Jew, keeping the Shabbos and everything because of this phenomenon that Professor Rieb showed him. So he told me if it's one book, if it is minimal, like Netanyahu comes here minimal, Israel comes, unbelievable, best meeting. So what we have here, you have here again, you have the word elections, as you see in red, coming Bechirot, higher a little bit, 5779, Likud party. Then I saw Messiah, Mashiach, what he's doing here. Even Netanyahu is not a Messiah. But again, as usually, what comes with Messiah, Teshuvah, parallel, by the way, very significant, tell you this is the time that we are now. By doing Shuvah, by repenting, we have Messiah. This is really what Abraham Kavieski says, that Messiah, but what is missing apparently is Shuvah repentance. No, who knows? We hope that it will be. But what is the most amazing thing, says that come here, elections this year, and Mashiach, Likud, and Netanyahu, exactly coming in Netanyahu, in Israel. But the most important, repentance, unbelievable, because nobody can argue that it's coincidence, because in one chapter, in Leviticus, unfortunately, if you go through those verses, it's a little frightening, because of them, terrible curses, if Jews will not keep the Torah, frightening. But in the end, God says, "Zacharti et briti Yaakov." Remember my covenant with Isaac, Abraham and Jacob, but repentance, this is what is necessary. So this is an unbelievable phenomenon to have in one chapter so many related words, you see. And also fits with the idea that by doing repentance, we have Messiah which is coming here. And really this election very likely will have great implication to this phenomenon. So let us hope that really the time will come already that Jews will do tshuva, repentance, and not out of terrible situation. Like the Gemara says, if Jews don't do willingly, so God appoint a cruel leader like Haman in Persia. We have today Lord Haman in Iran, the same thing. And they will threaten Israel, like the sixth war, which a lot of Jews did tshuva, then really the process of yeshiva balet tshuva started, So let us hope that Jews will do it really willingly and they will not have to wait for a really threatening situation that will force Jews to do tshuva. So very interesting and significant table, as we said, is in one book in Leviticus, exactly in very harsh verses. You can look at it, it's frightening. But there is a promise God will remember the covenant with Isaac, Jacob, Zakin, and Abraham, and will bring redemption. So this is important message. Let us really important. If somebody have some connection with Netanyahu, tell him he want to be a prime minister. Right? The Chabad Rebbe said that he will give the road to the Messiah, but no, let us really tell him that he's in the Torah in a very significant place, this meeting of elections and this year, which is small skiff, far away, and exactly his name comes here. It's not so simple. People think you can do it in every book, put this word in any book, will never come such a thing. So important and significant table relevant before Passover. This is a time to repent, to have Elijah coming and bring peace, tranquility, happiness, and joy to Israel, to the whole world.